Illustrated by Peter H. Reynolds. Rose was a dreamer, an adventurer. She explored the world in her fantastic teapot. Rose collected seeds from each place she visited to remember it by. The teapot became heavy and brimmed with seeds. It is time to plant my garden. There in the distance was a big, bustling city by the sea.
Welcome, friend. Sail up river. It's lovely there.
The harbor master called down to Rose. Thank you. I think I'll explore the city first, said Rose. She soon found herself in the busiest part of the city. And there, she spotted a dusty, forgotten stretch of earth. Rose pondered. This little patch needs some color. Rose began preparing the soil, imagining what a different, colorful place this could be. When she went to gather her seeds from the teapot, she noticed a flock of birds flying away from it. The birds seemed full and happy. Oh no! Rose slipped into the teapot and carefully gathered the few remaining seeds. She tucked them inside her pocket, then hurried from the dock. Rose planted her seeds and waited. Ugh, patiently. But nothing seemed to happen. The rains of spring made the soil too wet. The heat of summer made the ground too dry. Whoosh, the chill of autumn came too early. She waded through the snowy winter. Snow melted, the ground warmed, and still Rose waited, determined that her seeds would awaken. Word spread of Rose's faith in her garden. One warm spring day, a girl approached Rose with a gift. It was a paper flower. "I made it myself for your garden," the girl said, beaming. Thank you, said Rose. The next day, a boy appeared with his own handcrafted flower. Rose was delighted. This will be in good company when my own flowers bloom. Day after day, more children came to visit, each with a paper flower. Each told a story about coming to this city, having journeyed from all over the world, like seeds carried in a breeze. Before long, the garden was filled with color, glorious color, thousands of flowers, each one made of paper. Rose marveled as she waited among them. She heard a sound, a buzzing. She noticed a bee gently land on one of the flowers. She peered closer. This flower was not made of paper. She breathed in its sweet perfume. And then she noticed another real flower and another. Each flower, real or paper, had appeared around her because Rose believed. Her faith had gathered a garden and the stories of a city. Rose realized then that her travels were over. She was home. Home in this amazing garden. This splash of color in the middle of a great city, surrounded by stories and flowers. Here in Rose's garden, everybody's garden.